Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, we are slowing down to that Kodak speed, or these days it's an iPad speed, but you can see where it really does narrow for that amount of water. So this time of year, it is low, and that's why the salmon do return home for their inward migration. So it's not as impressive as it could be. You can actually see where the water line can get up to, so it's meters above. From where it is now. If you look over on the other side of that walkway, that bridge there, you see that white sign? That is the high water mark there. So it gives you an idea of how much, and this is still a lot of water that's coming through because it's very, very deep. So about 700 million liters of water can go through there almost every minute. To give you an idea of how much that is during the spring runoff, that's double the amount of Niagara Falls. So try to imagine yourself being a salmon and trying to get through this this force. So much so that about 100 years after Simon Fraser came through here, the Canadian National was building on the other side. You can see the tunnel. So they had to blast into that into the mountainside there. And it created even a more narrow gap. Anyone notice the those concrete, they're obviously man-made concrete blocks? Those are actually put there for the salmon. So because it made this Hell's Gate even more narrow, the salmon run was devastated in the early 1900s. People didn't even notice it until the First Nations brought it to their attention. First Nations people would come here in the fall and they would have large wicker or cedar baskets, and they would literally carry salmon to the other side of Hell's Gate because they knew how important it was for the salmon to return home to spawn. There were various attempts to try to figure out how to help the salmon get through Hell's Gate. At one point, they actually had an actual pulley system where people would be working and they would lift the salmon up with their cedar baskets, and then they put the salmon into wooden flumes and would carry them over to the other side. But instinctually, the salmon, they need to swim against the current. So that didn't work. And there were other ways they tried. Finally, through the efforts of the Canadian and Americans, they did those those concrete blocks. And you saw probably those slits. Those are little fish entries. So it kind of slows down the current for them. So when it's a really high water level, it allows the salmon to go off to the side and swim through Hell's Gate without having such a force of the turbulent waters. So that is that was Hell's Gate. It's a little tourist destination. Up top we have the Trans-Canada Highway, and that tramway allows tourists to come down and learn about the salmon run and learn about the history of Hell's Gate with the gold rush and the fur traders and so forth. It's one of the only places in the world where a gondola or a tram will actually go down to see a site. It'll always pick you up. Yeah. All right, so now that we have gone through the gates of hell,